There was this Kotak report that came out indicating that there were a lot of issues as far as Apollo hospitals are concerned, regulatory issues. So what we want to do is we want to speak to the management. Good afternoon, Suneeta. Thanks for joining us. The first question is, a recent brokerage note points out to several concerns. The first being, you know, regular headwinds like regulatory issues in terms of pricing cap, high capex, declining growth trajectory in the core Chennai cluster, etc. And they believe that this will continue over FY18. Do you agree that such headwinds will continue for your company?
I think we've met with some challenges for the past three quarters. To wish it away is not correct. But clearly there has been, you know, government regulations that has impacted not only the healthcare industry, but industry as a whole. And all of us know that, you know, the impact of demonetization, where there's 20% less cash in the hands of a consumer, has impacted everyone's both top line and bottom line. And for us, 55% of our patients were cash paying patients. So definitely that 55% has been hit. And because of that, we were not able to grow at the pace that we traditionally grew at. But I think growth is coming back because the way that digitization has helped to improve commerce and access to our facilities, I think this growth will definitely come back in the next quarter.
Okay, how big are these regulatory challenges in the form of pricing caps on stents and now knee implants that you are faced with currently?
These challenges are, because they were unexpected challenges in a sense, but I think we do have a deep understanding of these challenges now. If you look at healthcare in general, earlier we would price a component and leave out the procedure. It was an anomaly that existed. Now, you know, whatever the government might do in terms of putting a price cap on input costs, which is the material, I don't think will really affect our margins going forward into the future, because we are now repricing the service. So just like a hotel or a, you know, if you would fly from one place to the other, you know, you would buy a ticket and the entire service would be priced. So I don't think we need to focus on the input costs and get overly concerned about input costs. We've crossed that bridge.
Okay, so going ahead, do you anticipate capping of prices of other medical devices, let's say over the next 18 to 24 months?
You know, with the private sector actually handling 51% of India's healthcare, I think it would not really help the government if they were to come out with price regulations for the healthcare industry, because everyone knows that the disease burden and the demand supply gap is so huge in India that they need to encourage the private sector to actually get into the space. And as long as there are no new beds coming into the system, then we're actually, you know, there's actually nothing that's being done for the healthcare sector.
Okay, the report also says that the company's turnaround is basically on your ability to turn around Spectra. When do you see this happening for the company?
It should take another year for that to happen. And the reason that I say this is that if you look at Apollo today, about 30 to 40% of our surgeries are daycare surgeries. So I think we have a deep understanding of how, you know, the patient journey. We understand the interplay between technology, the skill of the doctor, and what the consumer wants. So clearly people would like to go into a smaller format store rather than go into a large hospital for a lot of these surgeries. And today we're doing open heart surgeries with robots. We're discharging patients in 48 hours. So clearly these are formats of the future. We have under that AHLL four formats. So I think that these are definitely something that they're more consumer facing than a pure hospital play.
Okay, as far as your Chennai hospital is concerned, there is a declining growth trajectory in your core Chennai cluster. And if you add the upfront cost for the Navi Mumbai hospital, then free cash flows will continue in the negative territory. When do you see these easing?
Next year, you'll see our free cash flows much better. Chennai is a cluster. There's a lot of focus on Chennai, but I think we need to understand that our other clusters are equally important. Bangalore is very important. Hyderabad has grown at 17%. Chennai was already large, where we had a market share of, we continue to have a market share of 20%. And we maintain and we grow this market share because we have different formats of care in Chennai. And clearly, this is working out really well because the daycare centers, the cradles, everything has started to do really well in Chennai. So if you don't see just Chennai, if you don't focus only on Chennai Hospital, but you look at our market share in the healthcare space, clearly we are the market leader in Chennai. And the good news is that Bangalore and Hyderabad and now New Bombay, all of them are moving in that direction.
Okay, let's talk about the other markets. How are you seeing growth in the markets outside of Chennai, and which hospitals are seeing traction currently?
Clearly, in Hyderabad, we're seeing an improvement in the revenue mix. We're seeing the ARPOB is growing, and occupancy is also picking up. Bangalore has grown. Today, they have close to 15% market share. With three hospitals in Bangalore, I think that the opportunity for growth is tremendous, and we can get to 20%, and we can look at a much richer case mix and better ARPOB. New Bombay, which we just started, less than two quarters, has started to improve significantly. Today we have 120 beds occupied out of 150 which are open now. And going forward, I expect to see that the losses diminish from New Bombay. So overall, the bottom line will look much better.
Okay, thanks so much, Ms. Reddy, for giving us a perspective.